story last year was like, oh, there's this big wall of institutional money coming. The only thing that needs to happen is we got to get some regulatory clarity, and we have to deal with the custody so that institutions don't have to hold, you know, private keys and their safes and stuff like that. And then it's all ready to come in. Is that still the view that if some things get solved in the sort of infrastructure side, that there's a lot of money on the sidelines?
There's certainly no question that custody and the regulatory aspect need some clarity, or at least need some work to build those out. They're complex issues.
Yeah.
Saying that, once that gets involved, that doesn't necessarily mean we've got a big rush, because right. If you look at the big institutional investors, they need a business case, really an investment case, to put money into something like Bitcoin. And if you take the position that Bitcoin is some form of digital gold, gold behaves in a certain way, and we've seen how it behaves over hundreds of years. We don't really have that for Bitcoin. So there's still, while some of the institutional investors understand this space very well, there's still the real question of what's the real value proposition for us to go into this versus, say, a more traditional class?
So this is one of the key aspects to why I'm not bullish on cryptocurrency yet. If you've been following my channel, I've said numerous times that any news that gets released, it doesn't really matter. I don't see us breaking the all-time highs of $850 billion until what he just mentioned. There really does need to be clear regulations and clear custodianship. A Bitcoin ETF would be a great example, which we're hoping will come out sometime this year in the end of 2018. But until then, whatever news you hear, you got to be careful, because we've had a couple of bounces and people are very optimistic, and I continue to be pessimistic, and I can see prices going down even more just until there's clear regulation and clear custodianship. So we're kind of in limbo right now, and if the market cap does go below $250 billion, I wouldn't be surprised. I would see it as a great buying opportunity. It might stay down there for a while, but I do feel like by October, November, December, I feel like by then we will really see some growth in this market and Bitcoin will finally get that bull market. But if there's news that shows that it's going to come sooner, then I obviously would change my position. But for me right now, my opinion is that if you're looking to make money in Bitcoin or cryptocurrency investing, you're going to have to be holding till 2019. And if you're looking to enter the market, I wouldn't be surprised if there's actually a lower dip in the next 2-3 months, especially if you don't have any clear news coming out. But let me know your thoughts about this, and I will talk to you soon.